Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss related rates. Let's do an example. All edges of a cube are expanding at a rate of 2 centimeters per second. How fast is the surface area changing when each edge is 3 centimeters? Let's work through it really carefully. Solution. Since the problem involves a cube, we'll start by drawing a cube. The way I draw a cube is I basically draw a square like this. And then I draw another square. And then I put dotted lines like this. And there we have our beautiful cube. We probably should have some variables in the problem, so let's label the edges because the problem is dealing with edges. So if we call this edge x, since it's a cube, all the edges are the same length. So this one is also x. The question is asking for the surface area, so we should come up with a formula or the surface area of a cube. You notice from the picture, the cube has 6 sides. It has one up top, one on the bottom, and then 4 all around. The area of any particular side is going to be x times x, which is x squared. So for all 6 sides, it'll just be 6x squared. All right, now let's write down what's given in the problem and what we actually need to find. So I'm going to write given. And over here, I'm going to write need. And you can do this for all related rates problems. You can write down what's given and what you need. Let's read it again. All edges of a cube are expanding at a rate of 2 centimeters per second. So we're given the rate of change of the edge, and it's expanding, so it must be positive. Since x is the variable we use to denote the edge, the rate of change of the edge is dx dt, and we're told that it's equal to 2. And it's positive because it's expanding. If this was a magically shrinking cube or something, then it would be negative. How fast is the surface area changing when each edge is 3 centimeters? So we're looking for the rate of change of the surface area. We called that s, so it will be ds dt, but it's more than this. We want to know this when each edge is 3 centimeters. So the edge is x. So basically, we draw a line and we put x equals 3. This basically means that we want to take ds dt and evaluate it when x is equal to 3. Now that we have our formula, we have what's given, we have what we need, we can go through and finish up the problem. So we're just going to compute the derivative. So ds dt. And we're looking at the formula here, s equals 6x squared. So we use the power rule, we bring down the 2, we get 2 times 6, which is 12. We subtract 1 from the exponent, so 2 minus 1 is 1, so we have a 1 here. Then times the derivative of the inside. Well, we're differentiating with respect to t, the inside function is x, so its derivative is called dx dt. Okay, we know something. We know dx dt, so this is equal to 12x, dx dt is 2, times 2. So we have now that ds dt is equal to, let's see, 2 times 12 is 24, so that's 24x. We're almost done. Now we need to plug in 3 because we want ds dt at the moment in time when x is equal to 3. So to finish up, we write ds dt, and we draw the line, x equals 3. It's really important to have correct notation. This is equal to, so basically this means we're plugging in 3 into our formula for ds dt, which is equal to 24x. This is 24 times 3. And this is equal to 72. Since its area and the original measurement given for length was centimeters, it's going to be centimeters squared, and the unit of time was seconds, so it'll be per second. So the surface area is changing at a rate of 72 centimeters squared per second when each edge is equal to 3 centimeters. Let's go ahead and do one more example. A spherical balloon is inflated with gas at a rate of 100 cubic centimeters per minute. How fast is the radius changing At the instant, the radius is 10 centimeters. Let's go ahead and work through this solution. Problem is talking about a spherical balloon. Furthermore, it says cubic centimeters per minute. Because it's cubic units, we know its volume. The formula for the volume of a sphere is V equals 4/3 pi r cubed. Now let's write down what we're given and what we need. We have given, and then we have need. And again, you can always do this for all of the related rates problems. I think it really, really helps. So the first sentence says, a spherical balloon is inflated with gas at a rate of 100 cubic centimeters per minute. That's the rate of change of volume. And again, we know that because it says cubic, and those are the units for volume. It's always cubic. So this tells us that dV/dt is going to be equal to 100. And that's because it's being inflated. If it was like a melting snowball, then it would be negative because the volume would be decreasing. How fast is the radius changing at the instant the radius is 10 centimeters? That's the rate of change of r with respect to time, dr dt. We want that at the very instant in time when the radius is 10, so r equals 10. This notation just basically means that we want to evaluate dr dt at r equals 10. All right, good stuff. Let's finish up. We're going to differentiate both sides of the equation v equals 4/3 pi r cubed. So we have dV/dt. The 4/3 and the pi are constants, so they hang out. We'll bring down the 3. We have 3 times 4/3 pi r squared, and we're using the power rule on r, so we brought down the 3, subtracted 1 from the exponent, times the derivative of the inside. The inside function is r, its derivative is dr dt. Now we can plug in what we know. We know dV/dt is 100. 100 is equal to, the 3's cancel, so we have 4 pi r squared dr dt. And since we're looking for dr dt, we can just divide both sides by 4 pi r squared. So divide by 4 pi r squared, divide by 4 pi r squared. So what's that going to give us? These cancel. We end up with dr dt equal to, and that's just going to be 25 over pi r squared, because the 100 and the 4 simplify. Now we have to plug in 10, so we have dr dt at the instant in time when r is equal to 10. That's equal to 25 over pi times 10 squared. That's equal to 25 over 100 pi. I'm going to write it again down here, a little bit bigger. So dr dt is equal to 25 over 100 pi, which simplifies to 1 over 4 pi. And the units here, well, they were centimeters, and this is the rate of change of radius, so it's just centimeters, and the units of time were minutes. And so that would be the rate of change of the radius at the instant in time that the radius is 10 centimeters. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.